So hello and welcome. Today I'm going to do a low-grade test. That's right, right here on my kitchen table, because I'm going to answer a question that I've had personally for a long time about GoPro action cameras. This is the GoPro Hero 9, the Hero 8, and the Hero 10 in order. What do you think I want to know? Well, a lot of people that listen to me and watch my videos wonder about camera equipment, and I want to tell you something. If you're using these to video your honeybees and things that are up close, you're going to want to know what's called the closest focal distance. That means how close can you focus on something that's right in front of your camera. They don't publish this in their specs. So we're going to do two lens settings. We're going to do the narrow setting. Everything is done at 1080p, 30 frames per second, and we're going to do narrow and wide. And also I have this high-tech measuring device. It's known as tape measure, and I'm going to call out the distances as we slide the cameras forward. And we're using a standard color chart, and this is an Arlo camera mounting bracket that I'm going to use because it puts the GoPro camera right at the center of the chart, so we will know exactly how much distortion there is also as we slide the camera closer. Let me tell you in advance, I'm pretty darn disappointed in the close focus capability of these cameras. The other thing is, look at the screen. If you're trying to look at your screen to see what the resolution of the screen itself is so poor, even on the 10 here, that you can't tell how well it's really focusing. Now, there might be some focus peaking functions. Focus peaking is when you enlarge the image on the electronic viewfinder here, but I'm going to save you the time and I'm going to tell you exactly which one works. The 8 gets you closer to your subject. That's right, the GoPro Hero 8 Black Edition focuses as close as 9 inches. The Hero 9 and the Hero 10 are shoulder to shoulder, probably with identical lensing, and they're only going to get you focused within 13 inches. And if you're a beekeeper and you're holding up your camera to those bees, you're going to wonder why, when you get home, they were out of focus. So you're going to want to keep them 13 inches or more.
GoPro Hero 8 Black Edition, Super View, 16 millimeters, 16 inches, 15. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 inches, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 inches. Narrow view, which is 27 millimeters, 18 inches, 16 inches, 14 inches, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. Hero 9 Black Edition Super View lens, 12 inches, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 7, 9, 11, 13. GoPro Hero 9 Black Edition, 15 inches. 13 inches. 11. 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 7, 9, 11, GoPro Hero 10, 4 inches. Five inches. Six inches. 7 inches. 8 inches. 9. 10. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. GoPro Hero 10, Super View, 16 millimeter wide angle, 12 inches, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Well, that's it. Here are 10, 9, and 8. The 8 gets you the closest and the sharpest.
GoPro Hero 10. GoPro Hero 9. GoPro Hero 8.
Now, just to explain, if you're trying to get macro images with these things, there are aftermarket lenses you can put on, the 9 and 10 in particular. We also have the 11 and 12 Black Edition. They don't perform any different for close focus video. So they're action cameras. They actually do their job pretty good. I also noticed that the distortion really was not bad at all with the narrow non-distortion lens, which was right at 27 millimeters. And let me know what you think. But just as fair warning here, if you're going to video honeybees with these things, or you want to get close, maybe you're videoing flowers. I don't know what you're doing. But the safe distance for all three cameras is going to be right around 13 inches from your subject. So I hope that's helpful. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a great day.